Good afternoon, Tamara and James. Daniel here from Pacific Toyota. Thank you so much for your inquiry this afternoon on this beautiful 2021 plate Landcruiser Prado VX, done around 85,000 Ks for $74,990 drive away. It's very, very well priced at the moment, especially for VX and all the gear that it has on it as well. That's drive away, including all your on-road costs, stamp duty charges, whatever registration has left on the vehicle as well. We'll also come with a PPSR report showing you the vehicle's never been written off, stolen, have any finance owned on it as well, okay? What I'll be doing today is a pre-purchase HD virtual tour of the vehicle. We'll go through the external paint, we'll go through the treaded tires, the underbody, all the 4x4 accessories that it has on the vehicle. Then we'll hop inside, go through the seating, what features has inside, as well as the service history, and start the car up, okay? So we are Pacific Toyota of Cairns. We are the biggest Toyota Lexus dealership in all of Queensland. We do have 2 yards up here in Cairns. This being the first one at 77 Mulgrave Road. We do not have another yard down the road at 235 Mulgrave Road as well. So between the 2 yards, stocking around 308 cars in stock at the moment, as you can see on our website. Soon to be 400. We're a high volume dealership. We sell at least 200 cars a month, and send at least 100 to sometimes up to 150 cars down to Brisbane alone. We sell our cars everywhere around the country, the Truganina, Minto. I've sold a car to Canberra last month. That's just what we're known for. If we're not the cheapest or best value in all of Queensland, we could be the cheapest or best value in all of Australia, all right? That's just what we're known for. We price our vehicles well. Happy to help you guys out and work out an awesome deal and send this down to Toowoomba for you guys. This was originally from Toowoomba as well. So we'll go through all the history of the car later on. But we'll go through the paint and panel first. This is how we sell that many cars for these HD virtual tours. Very, very picky, especially in my videos. I like to be very, very picky. But as you can see, beautiful reflection of the paintwork of the car. The only thing I'm noticing is the regular things that you would see on a used vehicle, stone chips. As you can see there, that's just me being picky. Anything like that, we can get it buffed and polished back and then touched up with color match paint as best as we can through our paint shops. But all nice and tidy in the front. We'll have a look under the bonnet. As you can see, the very reliable 2.8 liter diesel motor, just a single battery setup, as you can see there, but pretty nice and tidy. They do come on struts as well, so very, very easy to put up and put down as well. It's about to rain, so I'm going to quickly go through this really quickly, but as thorough as I can. Front right guard looks pretty neat and tidy, okay? Tread on the tyres, pretty good. Wrapped in your all-terrain Maxxis Razor rims. The size is 265-60 18-inch rims. No gutter rash, good tread as you can see. Color match ARB bull bar, as you can see. Still utilizing the front sensors as well as the front camera as well. So it's good that they've got that extra protection with the ARB bull bar. They've color matched it, add the light, the spotlights, add the two-way, and being able to still use those sensors, that those safety features that come with a VX. You do have that camera there, the front sensors, as well as it's winch compatible as well, as you can see. Okay, underbody looks pretty clean, but been kept in very good nick, James and Tamara. Only thing that I got to pick is get that touched up so it looks a little bit nicer there and send it back. But that's just on the bull bar anyways. And then just little touch-ups there that we need to do down there. But besides that, on the front, besides, you know, your general wear and tear, your scratches and stuff on the bull bar, it's all solid and stuff like that. All the wiring, all the paint work has been done in very good condition. Okay, that's me being picky. Front left guard here. Obviously being the darker vehicle car, like your graphites, your silvers, your blues, your blacks, grays and stuff like that, you see most of the scratches. That's the point of this video. I'll show you as best as I can. Being very, very picky, you can see those scratches there. Just being the darker color vehicles, anything like that, going through the detailing stage, we'll get it buffed and polished and see if they can come out, but still presents well. You can see the beautiful reflection of the paint. Okay, front left tread, as you can see there. Very good. You have those safety cameras up there, which I'll go through with you, with all the safety features that this car comes with. This car does, the mirrors do fold in and out when you lock it and stuff like that as well. You do have the blind spot monitoring there, as you can see. Any cars in your blind spot, they will go orange. So I've got the keys in my pocket, as you can see. Hover my hand over these two lines. The car will lock, as you can see. Mirrors fold in. obviously locked. Then I walk up to the car and then I can open it because the key's in my pocket and the mirrors fold out as well, as you can see. But all nice and tidy, the door cards as you can see there. Genuine Land Cruiser floor mats as you can see. The service history, as you can see, it was an ex-fleet vehicle from Toowoomba, bought from Toowoomba Toyota. Go through the service history. That was done through Black Toyota, which is in Roma. Looks like they've missed this one here, but besides that, they've got every other one. Toowoomba Toyota there, Roma. They could have been traveling between Roma and Toowoomba, as you can see. But very, very well serviced, as you can see. All right, I'm pretty sure that's the last service done for us at Pacific Hino. That's our reconditioning center. If it comes through and needs a service, we'll service the car. But as you can see, got always owner's manual service and warranty booklets there. Being the VX, you get the nicer interior on the seats, get the electronically adjustable seats, you get the heated and cooling seats as well. JBL sound system. I'll go through more features once we get on the other side, but presents well. Have a look at the grain. It's got a dash mat underneath, no cracks or anything like that. Okay, well, the grain looks pretty sick, as you can see there. Presents well on the interior. Okay, fin plate there, side steps look pretty good, you know, just your general smaller scratches and stuff like that, as you can see here. But a buff and polish will make it look a little bit nicer, but I'm just trying to be as upfront as I can to you guys. Okay, general scratches here, but still presents well. Could do with another clean here, to be honest with you. Maybe had a baby seat here in the past, I believe, but that's just me being very, very picky. Yeah, it looks like it did have a baby seat, as you can see. That just needs a better clean, which I'll do for you, which we'll do for you. But that's the point of these videos. Go through everything with you. Genuine floor mats at the back here. Got all the aircon controls. You got the 12 volt down here as well. Pockets on either side. Seats present well. Fold down flat. Got those points if you need it, as you can see there. We'll go through all the things in the back. It did have a previous sticker here. Looked like the previous owner had a sticker here. We just need to get that a buff and polish. But that's the point of these videos, to show you the car in its raw condition. On the rear tailgate here, as you can see, just your general wear and tear scratches. But I reckon a buff and polish will make it a lot nicer. This is on the paint. I think this is on like that plastic, as you can see. But yeah, just your general wear. Some of them are rubbing off because it's just from the rain and stuff like that. As you can see, the weather up here in Cairns. But a buff and polish will make that this vehicle on the tailgate look a bit more representable, but still presents well, as you can see. As you can see with the flat tailgate, you have that option of pulling that window up as well with that little button there, and then you can close it, as you can see. Then you have this, which can basically open up wide, which people love. Hold it there, all nice and clean. Obviously you got this privacy cover that you can put up and drag all the way out to here. Obviously people won't be able to see what you have in the boots and stuff like that. It's got a genuine Land Cruiser Prado floor mat, as you can see there. You got that 100 watt plug. Sorry, I just gotta move this out of the way for a second. All right, so we can pull these seats back so you can see. As you can see, the rear seats present well as well. Okay, basically have a look underneath. No rips, tears or any stains. Looks like they've kept this car in the best condition, opted in to get all the little things to protect the vehicle as well. Dash mat, floor mat, cargo mat. Got a tow bar and ball, as you can see. Still utilizing the rear parking sensors. Your rear reversing camera is there. That's where your spare tire is kept underneath as well, Tamara and James. All right, as you can see, there's that existing sticker that we just have to get buffed and polished out for you. You can see a little buff and polish will make that look a little bit nicer. You got privacy glass on the rear half of the car, as you can see. It's just what they do on cars nowadays, newer cars, as you can see on the Nissan Navara there. It just makes it seem a little bit harder to have a look inside. Not actually UV protected, but these cars do look awesome with what's called tinting as well. I've just put the cover there, but on the side, pretty nice and clean as well. Okay, door cards, general wear and tear. I reckon this is from the kids on the right hand side of the car. That's just all plastic trimming there. Okay, smaller scratches here that we can get touched up for you. A little buff and polish, I reckon, around this area here, here, and here. This one, I'm not confident we can get that buff and polish. Buff and polish will make a little bit look a little bit nicer, but that is a scratch. All right, we'll hop in to the car. As you can see, automatic windows. All the way around, center locking, electronically adjusted seats. You've got lumbar support as well on the bottom here. Automatic lights, wipers, mirrors fold in and out, adjust them electronically, push button start. But yeah, we'll get into the car. Two genuine keys, as you can see there as well. Okay, nice little dash that pops up there. Got your voice recognition, your multimedia settings, your Bluetooth controls here. You've got your lane departure alert, as you can see there, active. Once you set your cruise control on the bottom here, you can change the distance for adaptive cruise control as well. Obviously with those cameras, that's for adaptive cruise control, your lane departure warning, as well as that road sign there. Go past the 40, 60, 80 sign, that will pop up there as well and show you what speed that you've gone past. Sorry, someone's trying to give me a call. I'll call them after the video. But as you can see, inbuilt multimedia. I've listened to some music, 102.7. Nice and crisp sound with the JBL sound system as well. That's an awesome song, good sound system, as you can see. So we go to maps here, should have inbuilt navigation if we go back to where we are. Just shows you where we're at the moment, but it doesn't show you the actual map. But it should show you the actual map, which I'll try navigate soon. But yeah, you can put in your address, where you want to go, select it, and it'll basically take you there. Auto settings are pretty easy. Different source settings, AM, FM, DAB, USB, Bluetooth, as well as Miracast. We'll go to menu and show you setup, projection settings. As you can see, it does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto as well. Okay, all right, but pretty simple to use. Okay, all right, aircon controls is pumping at the moment, as you can hear. But very, very nice, cold and powerful. Dual climate control as well. You can control the rear aircon controls as well. As you can see, I'll turn that off as well. But yeah, you have all the vents all along there for the rear aircons. But yeah, you can have a different temperature on the passenger side with the dual climate control. Very, very simple to use, okay? Compartment here to leave a few things. That's where your two-way is. So you just have to connect it into that GME port down there. Cooler box with the VXs, turn that off and power that on. Just simple button there, is nice and cool there, as you can hear, fan working. But yeah, heated and cooled seats, as you can see, ventilated and heated seats, I mean. 12 volt there, got your USB for your multimedia, which probably need to clean there. But yeah, put into reverse, as you can see. Got your bird's eye view, that's utilizing all the cameras around the car. That's your rear reversing camera as well. Okay, but yeah, put into S mode. You can manually shift the gears if you like as well. Press view, you can see the camera at the front as well as the bird's eye view down there. Auto up, your parking sensors on and off there as well. Fold in your mirrors. Automatic lights, as you can see there. Automatic wipers, as you can see there. All your, what's good, cruise control, adaptive cruise control, blind spot monitoring, and different menu setups there as well. As you can see, car sitting at 86,979 kilometers. The next service isn't due until 97,000 kilometers, or the 11th month of this year. So it looks like with these cars, you get service every 6 months or 10,000 Ks, and it has been serviced through us as well, which is in the booklet, and that's when the next service is. Okay, steering wheel all nice and tidy. Dash mat, dash, no cracks or anything like that as well. Tamara and James, steering wheel, no fingernail marks, no fading or anything like that as well. Okay, normal handbrake, all your rear diff lock, second gear start, downhill control, traction control, high four, low four, cup holders, different compartments. But yeah, electronically adjust your steering wheel as well, wherever you need it to go. But yeah, watch the kids as well when you're driving. But presents well inside and out. Obviously, just being the darker colored vehicle, you just see all the scratches and stuff like that. But it still presents well, as you can see all the scratches that I showed you. You know, especially for its K's, it's been well looked after. Gone the extra mile with all the safety features kept on the car, the bull bar, light bar, two-way, you've got the dash mat, you've got the floor mats, you've got the cargo barrier in there as well. But yeah, very well looked after. I appreciate it, guys. Let me know what you think. Can't wait to send this down to Toowoomba with the 79 workmate that I just sold down there as well. Appreciate it, guys. Let me know what you think. Happy to help you guys out. Talk soon. Take care.